गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट मेटल्स इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो, नाउ टूडे वी विल बिगिन विद नॉन मेटल्स. वॉट इज नॉन मेटल्स? सी, नॉन मेटल्स, देर आर 24 नॉन मेटल्स नोन टूडे. ओके, हाउ मेनी नॉन मेटल्स? 24 नॉन मेटल्स, 24 नॉन मेटल्स वी हैव एट प्रेजेंट इन टूडेज टाइम. ओके, सो but they are in different types. Okay, they are in solid, liquid, as well as present in gases also. Okay, so in solid there are 12 non-metals. In solid we have 12 non-metals. In liquid we will have only one non-metals. Okay, and in gases we will have 11 non-metals. Okay, so 12 plus 1 13, 13 plus 11 we will have total 24 non-metals. Okay, so the non-metals in case of solid are C, they are carbon, phosphorus, sulfur, okay, I think iodine. Okay, these are the cases of solid, etc. There are many more present non-metals in the case of solid. In case of liquid only one we will have, and that is bromine. Okay, that is bromine. It is written there in your book. Okay, and here in gases we will have hydrogen, lithium, hydrogen, argon, then krypton, all noble gases we will have. Okay, neon, helium, chlorine, fluorine, there are many more, etc. are non-metals present in the gases. Okay, so total 24 non-metals we will have. Now we will study about their characteristics. Okay, so their characteristic is totally different from the characteristics of metals. Okay, as we have already discussed about metal, so here we will discuss about non-metal. Okay, so first characteristic. Okay, first characteristics is that solid non-metal are non-lustrous. So non-metal is non-lustrous. Okay, non-lustrous. Non-lustrous means what? It don't have shining surface. It do not have shining surface. Lustrous means what? A shining surface. Okay, is known as lustrous. Mostly metals are lustrous, but non-metals are non-lustrous. They don't have shining. Okay, except we will have graphite. Graphite is a form of carbon which is which is a non-metal. Graphite is a exception which is a form of carbon, and it is a non-metal which have a lustrous surface, which is a lustrous. Graphite, you all have seen your pencil. The pencil, you will have seen the pencil by which you write is actually a graphite needle. Okay, pencil ki jo nok hoti hai wo kali jo dikhti hai wo chamakti hai, aapne dekha hoga jab aap usko cutter se kya hai usko sharp kar dete hai to wo dekhte hain aap wo chamakti hai, wo actually mein jo black color ki jo nok hoti hai wo graphite hi hota hai, that is a graphite. Okay, aur wo ek non metal hai which have a lustrous. Okay, second is solid non-metals are not hard and have low tensile strength. It is also not hard. Okay, not hard and very less tensile strength is also very bad. Low tensile strength. Okay, low tensile strength. Tensile strength, I have told in my first video what is tensile strength. Tensile strength is actually the strength of the metals or strength of the element by which we can decide that it is a hard or it is a soft. Okay, so if a metal is hard, so its tensile strength is good enough. Okay, if a metal is hard, if a element is hard, then its tensile strength is good enough and it will be counted in the case of metal. Okay, but here the tensile strength will be low and metal is not hard. Okay, it can be broken very easily. Okay, by applying only less effort it can be broken. Okay, so tensile strength is very low, not very hard. in the case of non-metal. Okay, then third, in this also there is an exception written here, that is diamond. Diamond is also a form of carbon other than graphite, and diamond is the hardest solid. Okay, diamond is the hardest solid known. Understand, the if in the question it is asked that name the hardest metal, name the hardest non-metal, then what you will write? Diamond. Okay, then you will write diamond, and the lustrous non-metal, then you will write graphite. So exceptions given in the characteristics are very important. Okay, question can be made from there, so you need to study it very attentively. Third is non-metals are non-sonorous. Okay, it is also non-sonorous. Non-sonorous means what? It cannot make noise. Okay, while if you will struck anything against that non-metal, it do not make noise. Okay, that is, they do not produce a clink when struck against the hard object. Like metals, what happens? I have explained in my previous video that the utensils at your home is actually a metal. Okay, when that glass and all, what happens, slips from your hand and fallen down, what happens? It makes noise. It makes a clink type noise. Okay, but in case that is the sonorous. Okay, that is only the sonorous. Sonorous means kya hai? Awaaz nikalna. मेटल्स क्या है, जैसे कि थाली, ग्लास, बर्तन या आपके घर के गिरते हैं, एक दूसरे से टकराते हैं, तो क्या है, एक आवाज़ क्रिएट होती है ना. लेकिन नॉन मेटल्स में क्या है, ये नॉन सोनोरस होते हैं. इसमें क्या होता है, कोई आवाज़ नहीं क्रिएट होती. इसमें चाहे जितने हार्ड सब्जेक्ट्स ऑब्जेक्ट से इसको मारा जाए या फिर इसको इस पर स्ट्रक किया जाए, इसमें आवाज़ नहीं निकलेगी. तो ये नॉन सोनोरस होते हैं. देन नॉन मेटल्स हैव लो डेंसिटी ऑल्सो. Metals have high density, non-metals have low density. Few given in the table: phosphorus 1.82, sulfur 2.07, graphite that is carbon 2.25, diamond that is also a carbon 3.52. Okay, the liquid non-metal is bromine, has a high density. Okay, the bromine which is in the liquid case, the one only one non-metal which is in the liquid is bromine, which has a very high density. Okay, then non-metals have low melting and boiling point also. Okay, so fourth is low density, okay, and fifth characteristic is low melting and boiling point. Low melting point and boiling point. Okay, it has low melting point and low boiling point, and also low density. पॉइंट नंबर फाइव, सॉलिड नॉन मेटल्स मेल्ट्स एंड बॉयल्स एट लो टेम्परेचर. ओके, तो इफ इट इज अ नॉन मेटल, देन व्हाट हैपेंस, इट कैन मेल्ट एट वेरी लो टेम्परेचर. ओके, एंड कैन बी बॉइल्ड वेरी इजली एट अ वेरी लो टेम्परेचर. ओके, सो यू हैव टू रीड ऑल दीज प्रॉपर्टीज. सिक्स्थ इज सी एक्सेप्शन रिटन हेयर, कार्बन मेल्ट्स एट वेरी हाई टेम्परेचर 3550 डिग्री सेल्सियस. ओके, रेस्ट इज सिमिलर, इट इज गिवन इन द टेबल. सिक्स्थ इज सॉलिड नॉन मेटल्स आर ब्रिटल रैदर देन मैलेबल. सॉलिड नॉन मेटल्स आर ब्रिटल. ओके, फोर्थ इज सिक्स्थ इज दे आर ब्रिटल. ब्रिटल मीन्स क्या, ब्रिटल मीन्स वो क्या है, शुष्क है ना, बहुत ही कमजोर. ब्रिटल दे आर, हल्का सा ही अगर उसको हम बीट करेंगे, उस पर बीट करेंगे तो क्या हो जाएगा, वो टूट जाएगा. हल्का सा उसमें मतलब किसी चीज़ से उसको हम ठोकेंगे तो टूट जाएगी. ठीक है, जैसे कि इन केस ऑफ मेटल क्या होता है, हम जैसे कि कोई मेटल ले लिए, क्या कहते हैं, लाइक आयरन एंड ऑल, उस पर हम उसको अगर हम क्या हथौड़े हथौड़े से उस पर पीट रहे हैं तो फैलेगा, टूटेगा नहीं, वो फैलेगा, वो मैलेबल है. इट वो क्या है? फैलेगा, पतला होता चला जाएगा और फैलता चला जाएगा. लेकिन यहाँ पे क्या है, इन केस ऑफ नॉन मेटल वो फैलेगा नहीं, वो टूट जाएगा, क्योंकि इट इज़ अ ब्रिटल, वो क्या है, कमजोर है, इट इज़ नॉट अ हार्ड. ओके, सिक्स्थ इज ओवर. नाउ सेवन, सॉइल नॉन मेटल्स आर नॉन डक्टाइल. ओके, इट इज़ ऑल्सो नॉन डक्टाइल. सेवन, नॉन डक्टाइल. non-ductile means what? It cannot be drawn into wires. Non-ductile means what? It cannot be drawn into wires. Metals से हम लोग जानते हैं कि हम लोग के यहाँ जो कॉपर की वायरिंग होती है ना, गोल्ड वायरिंग, सिल्वर वायरिंग, बहुत महंगी महंगी वायरिंग है, ये सब क्या है? एक मेटल है, ठीक है. मेटल्स को हम वायर में ला सकते हैं, ठीक है, उसको हम वायर में कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं, लेकिन नॉन मेटल्स को वायर में हम कन्वर्ट नहीं कर सकते. वाई? बिकॉज दे आर नॉन डक्टाइल. ओके, नॉन मेटल्स आर बैड कंडक्टर ऑफ हीट. ओके, एंड नॉन मेटल्स आर बैड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू. ओके, हियर दिस, बैड कंडक्टर It is a bad conductor of heat and bad conductor of electricity. That means what? It do not allow heat energy to flow through them, and not does it allow electricity to flow through them. So these are the properties of non-metals, which is just opposite to the properties of metal. Okay. So if metal is sonorous, then they are non-sonorous. Metal will be ductile, so they will be non-ductile. Metal will be malleable, so they will be brittle. Okay, like this. Metal is hard, they are not hard. Metal have high tensile strength, they have low tensile strength. Metal have high boiling point, melting point, they have low melting point, boiling point. Metals are good conductor of heat and electricity, they are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Okay, so these are the characteristics along with the exceptions is very important in the cases of characteristics. Okay, now further it is written in the book, distinguish between metals and non-metals. How will you distinguish whether it is a metal and non-metals? Okay, so you will discuss, understand whether the given element is a metal or non-metal only by their characteristics. If you know the characteristics of metal and also you know the characteristics of non-metal, then you can easily identify whether the given element, the element which you hold in your hand, is a metal or a non-metal. If it has a properties which is illustrated in the metals cases, then it will be a metal. And if it have properties which is illustrated in non-metal case, then it is a non-metal. So it is very easy. Okay, if you know the properties or characteristics of metal and non-metal, then it will be very easy for you to identify whether the given element is a metal or a non-metal. Okay, so it is written over there, say 6-7 points, you have to read it. Okay, given in the page number 52. Okay, you can read it from your book, it is written clearly. Now next we have to study about metalloids. Okay, metalloids is actually a semi-metal. Okay, metalloids is actually a semi-metal and semi-non-metal. Semi-metal and semi-non-metal. Okay, metalloids is actually a semi-metal and semi-non-metal. Semi-metal and semi-non-metal means what? It has few properties of metal as well as few properties of non-metal. Okay, those element which possess few properties of metal and few properties of non-metal, they are named as metalloids. Okay, now see here, here also few properties is given about metalloids. The first is, metalloids are hard solid. Okay, they are hard solid. Second is, they may or may not have luster. That means they can have luster and they also cannot have luster. For example, germanium, antimony and tellurium are lustrous, but silicon and arsenic are not. Okay, and all these are metalloids. They have density intermediate between those of metals and non-metals. That means what? Density will be in between of metals and non-metals. Their abilities to conduct heat and intermediate between those of metals and non-metals. Okay, so they can conduct heat. Okay, so they can conduct heat, which is a property of metal, okay, not a non-metal. Metals conduct heat, so they also can conduct heat, but very slow, at a very slow rate. Fifth, except some example, arsenic and antimony being good conductor of electricity, metalloids, example silicon, germanium, are semiconductors. Okay, only few semiconductors can be considered as a good conductor of heat and electricity, rest are not. Okay, so these are the properties by which we can know that that metalloids is actually a intermediate elements between metals and non-metals. Metalloids actually में क्या होते हैं? Metalloids वो होते हैं जिनके पास कुछ property metals की भी होती है और कुछ property non-metals की भी होती है. ये actually में क्या होते हैं? अगर इनको हम एक line से एक table में arrange करें तो सबसे पहले तो metal आते हैं, ठीक है, metal. उसके सबसे last में non-metal आते हैं, ठीक है, non-metal, ठीक है. और जो बीच की जग, बीच के जो एलिमेंट होते हैं उनको हम लोग मेटेलॉइड्स बोलते हैं, ठीक है. जो बीच के होते हैं वो मेटेलॉइड्स होते हैं, ठीक है, बीच के जो एलिमेंट्स होते हैं मेटेलॉइड्स. तो यहाँ से मेटल से चलते हैं तो कुछ प्रॉपर्टी मेटल्स की मेटेलॉइड्स में आ जाती है और नॉन मेटल्स से इधर आते हैं तो कुछ प्रॉपर्टी नॉन मेटल्स की भी मेटेलॉइड्स में आ जाती है, ठीक है. तो मेटेलॉइड्स मतलब क्या है कि अगर इनको हम एक टेबल में अरेंज करें तो सबसे पहले मेटल्स आएंगे, उसके बाद फिर मेटेलॉइड्स आएंगे जिनके पास कुछ प्रॉपर्टी मेटल की और कुछ प्रॉपर्टी नॉन मेटल की, और लास्ट में क्या आएंगे? नॉन मेटल्स आएंगे, ठीक है. लाइक दिस दे अरेंज, ऑल एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज लाइक दिस ओनली, ओके. ऑल एलिमेंट्स विच आर नोन टू अस, विच आर प्रेजेंट इन अवर नेचर आर अरेंज लाइक दिस ओनली, ओके. फर्स्ट वी विल हैव मेटल, देन मेटेलॉइड्स, देन एट लास्ट वी विल हैव नॉन मेटल्स, ओके. सी जनरल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल नॉन मेटल इज इट इज गिवन देयर इन अ टेबल, यू हैव टू रीड इट, ओके. सो हैव एक्सप्लेन क्लियरली अबाउट मेटल देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स अबाउट देयर एक्सेप्शंस, देन नॉन मेटल्स देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स अबाउट देयर एक्सेप्शंस, अबाउट मेटेलॉइड्स एंड देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, ना, वॉट आर मेटेलॉइड्स आई हैव एक्सप्लेन थॉरली. नाउ आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू हाउ यू कैन डिस्टिंग्विश any metal, whether it is a metal or a non-metal, that is you can distinguish it by their characteristics, okay. Now we have to study from the alloy, so from alloy we will study in our next video, okay. Till then you have to read it till here, and don't only watch video, okay, and just watching video will be not sufficient, you have to read it from your book also, okay. I have seen that many of the student do not watch video properly, and that is why they have not scored very good marks in the examinations. Thank you.